It's a disruptive power that the people have, but it is a power the people have. The people shall rule. There is a final appeal. The initiative and the referendum were first proposed by the Populist Party in 1892. It was a general national movement of government reform, where you would get so many signatures and a measure could be placed right on the ballot for vote of the people. The whole thing is based on a great mistrust, or no trust at all, of the legislative process. In North Dakota, the background for the initiative and referendum is really in the boss Alexander McKenzie era. I don't think there was another state in the Union as controlled by a political boss system as North Dakota. And it takes a while for people to realize that you can wield some political power through use of the initiative and the referendum. My favorite example of this is the North Dakota parking meters. It started in 1948 with Howard Henry of West Hope. He initiated a measure, and the people voted with him. Yes, we don't want parking meters. And that was in June of 1948. Well, the cities, of course, looked at this for street maintenance, and so the cities then initiated a measure a few months later in the fall election to reinstate the parking meters. And the people said no, you know. And then the legislature, after a three-year waiting period, reenacted parking meters. And Howard Henry again referred the measure of parking meters, and today we don't have parking meters. Grassroots democracy. It worked. Many times the first try doesn't go, but with the case of movies, there were quite a few blue laws passed before World War I, and one of those was that you shall not show movies or play baseball on Sunday. And towns and theater operators tried twice, and no go. And then finally, in the early 30s, the third try legalized movies on Sunday. I would say that the majority of initiated and referred measures over the years have dealt with matters of finance, matters of tax. It's the one place, I think, where people think they can control their own destiny somehow.
But I think it's time that North Dakota wake up to the fact that we decide who will win and who will lose. We don't need people.
If we go back to the Robert McCarney era of the 60s into the 70s, we have McCarney even in the halls of the legislature saying, you do this, I'm going to refer it. Time magazine ran a nice article on Robert McCarney, calling him the king of the referral, the national king. McCarney knew how to refer a measure. And although he himself was not a very articulate person, yet he saw himself as one of the people. He saw himself as the champion of the people.
Do you know who pays the government and the cost to run this government? It isn't the guys that are millionaires, the guys make 100 or 200,000. It's the lower and middle income pays all of that.
And I think a lot of people look to him that way, that here's the Supreme Court, here's the executive, here's the legislature, and here's the king of the referral. And it did influence legislators.
They doubled and tripled the $5,000 to $15,000 taxable income.
Well, if you argue that democracy is the ideal, the more democracy you have, the better you are, then North Dakota is a better place. The reverse side of that is that it makes planning more difficult. Yeah, it's really democratic. But at the same time, it's a disruptive force. More recently, there have been individuals who have, I think, attempted to emulate the success of McCarney in seeing themselves as the champion of the people of North Dakota, using the media to advantage in referral campaigns. So he's the architect of the type. And I think the people have the responsibility to study the issue and to make some kind of judgment about it. But the thing is to be informed.